let's talk about designing interfaces and applications for the healthcare industry. This is going to be great content for designers who are looking and picking different industries, what the industries they might be interested in. I think something like this would have been very helpful, I'm sure, for people, you know, like if you had this information, right? Like going into this, hey, if this is going to be right for you or not. So we'd love to kind of educate the young designers who are still kind of choosing their industry, if you will. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes, of course. Yeah. So backstory. So what happened is, you know, Novo Nordisk, they is the Danish company. They do have, you know, their branch in New Jersey, but this is a Danish, you know, headquarter initiative. And say, hey, we've been doing molecule for a long time and people are starting to get into the digital health space. So you can see a lot of like startup company trying to start doing those kind of stuff, and also including the big guy, like Amazon is doing PillPack now. And so they are like, hey, we need to compete, right? But they don't quite know how. And then doing things in Denmark is way too close to the headquarters. So that's why they spin off and kind of build a satellite office, you know, in Seattle, to kind of like do just mostly R&D. And the digital health is one of the things that they want to try to explore here as well. They're starting off trying to bring in the, like, you know, the consultant, the one of the big one, right? Didn't work out, and say, hey, we want to be more nimble. So they started to building the team. So, and then I was brought in to help doing the UX and UI. They don't even have the name, like the title for it. My official title is concept developer. It's like, fine, like, hey, what do you want me to do? It's like, okay, there's mostly UI, UX stuff, designing, great, product design, excellent. And so this is like a really starting from scratch, and we want to go out and actually learn about what patients' needs are like, right? And this is really interesting because it's actually attached to disease itself, not by personality, right? Not by races, origin, or like, you know, anything else. So you going in, basically you as 100 million people, basically you want to solve the problem for everybody that, you know, that they have. So, you know, the first time that, you know, what we want to do, we did is trying to actually understand their pain points, right? We always want to solve the user problem. You're going in and we do a lot of insight study. We were really fortunate to have a really good researcher. He's excellent, like awesome. Kirk, shout out to you. You are and best, you know, user research ever. So he kind of bring us along to the user insight study. We go and visit, you know, the people at their home, right?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like, you know, they invite us to the home. We go talk for like a couple hours, learn about like, how did they actually find out? What did they feel like, you know, understand? And, you know, we try to digest and try to understand their, you know, their pain point, their, you know, what's blocking them, right? Because everybody wants to get better. Like nobody like poking their, you know, tummy with the like needles. That's not fun. But that's something that they need to do to keep themselves alive.
Yeah.
That's like the bar is really low at that point. And we try to kind of digest, and we did some design sprint and see how, like what kind of products should we do?
What kind of things should we have? Were you able to show those concepts back to the people, or?
To the people, to that specific audience, that person, no. But we do have like repeating person that actually come in for our user study that we were to do that. Because, you know, a lot of this were R&D, so a lot of this are confidential. Mm. Right? We cannot quite show them what we try to do. So, but yeah, we've actually tried to revisit them again and again, and we kind of explain to them like, you know, some rough concept of what you're trying to do. Would that fit into their lifestyle, right? Because, you know, they will use it if it actually fit into their lifestyle. Like, you know, healthcare is one thing that people will try their best to follow, but if you're making it hard for them, they will just drop out.
Yeah.
So that's kind of like, you know, the adherence is super low. Yeah. Right. Remember, like taking one pill every morning is, you thought it's really easy, but once you try it out, actually, you know, quite difficult.
Like, oh, yeah. I have the same problem even with just simple vitamins.
Right. We've
tried different ways, like, you know, try putting it near the water where I drink water. So, like, the theory is if it's near what I'm drinking, you know, and even that, yeah. So it's really hard habit changing or you know, injecting yourself into habits is,
right. Yeah. And then also like including the stigma of the, you have diabetic, you are lazy, you like, you know, you eat too much, which is totally not true, by the way, right? They want to improve, and that's some ways that we, the system was just, you know, setting up for failure most of the time. Mm-hmm. That's what happened. That's kind of what we found out and say like, okay, the way that doctors view the patients and the way that they try to treat them at home, they did not consider user experience or user needs into their consideration at all. They were almost coming in as a commander and say like, hey, this is what you must do.
Right.
Do that. But you cannot force them to do it. Right. That's right. Why you see some weird stuff and say like, you know, the bell that actually recording if you take the pill or not type of stuff. Because they're kind of coming from that kind of point of view and say like authoritarian, right? It's like, you must do this.
Yeah.
And they, in their mind, they said like, it's so obvious that you're going to do it, because you don't do it, you die.
Right.
But people just like your day-to-day life, like, you know, things get into the way, sometimes they forgot. Yeah. How can we help them? Right. Yeah. So I was trying to bring in this kind of thinking into the healthcare. How do we fit into their lifestyle? What kind of thing can we build? How kind of thing can we personalize, and what kind of thing we can make it better? Mm-hmm. So we kind of break it down into like multiple like work stream, right? So a team were kind of working on the device, like, you know, somehow can, how do we bring in the data from the pen into the, you know, the system? So we know that, you know, everybody is like almost like, you know, the easiest one is like a checkbox and say like, you actually did that, right? So when you go to the doctor, you say, you've been taking the medication like we're supposed to, good. It's still not improving. We can do something else.
Right.
Before the conversation, like, have you been taking medication? Your number is not better. Do you really take medication? Right. And that, at that point, you know, the patient was like taking it back, like, I did.